This is a great movie. You don't understand. Star. She just.
I don't care about the star. I hate scary movies.
No, Stacey. You understand, though. No. This is for me. I mean, you know, I do things for you. You do something for me. But it's one time, please.
Well, since I'm already here.
Well, you know. Man, you always got a scary
attitude. I'm sorry.
I'm the movie alert! Woo!
Yes!
Hurry up. Sit down.
Thank goodness you're back. I think she's about to get it. Oh, if that were me, I would be out of there.
You tell me.
Corey Gillis, 555-0176. Hot flush, Corey. Prank calls or a criminal offense. It's prosecuted under Penal Code Law 653M. Hope you enjoyed the movie.
Time to change numbers again?
Nah, it'll die off. It's opening weekend.
Mr. Batten, here, you're late. Don't forget about the root beer mixer tonight at Delta Landis.
Oh, Holly, I don't think I can go.
What? Come on, you promised. You need to get over this.
I'm fine.
I'm fine. I see that remark is always stretched tightly across your face.
Check out the news.
Last night at a sneak preview showing of the movie Gasher. Authorities won't release anything except for the two victims, Maureen Evans and Phil Stevens, were both IUE seniors.
Where's Danny?
He's got film theory.
What you're saying is that the killer's influence was based on the movie itself.
That is so moral majority. You can't blame real life violence on TV entertainment.
Hello, the guy was wearing a ghost mask just like in the movie. It's directly responsible.
No, it's not. Movies are not responsible for our actions.
So you're saying that someone is trying to make a real-life sequel?
Gasher 2? Why would anybody want to do that? Sequels suck.
It's a common fact that many sequels have succeeded their original.
Name one. Alien's far better than the first.
Yeah, well, there's no accounting for taste.
Thank you, Ridley Scott rules. Name another. T2.
You've got it bad for Cameron.
The horror genre was destroyed by sequels. No, wait. I got it. The Empire Strikes Back.
Luke, I am your father.
We'll continue the sequel discussion tomorrow.
So, Mr. Originality, what would you make different?
I'd let the geek get the girl.
It's happening again, Danny.
A lot happens in movie theaters these days. People get maimed, murdered, robbed, shot. Multiplexes are very dangerous places to be.
Yeah, and you're in extreme denial.
And you should be too. This has nothing to do with us.
You know what happened in Connersville. You can't deny it.
Yeah, I know. And I don't want to go back there. Can't we just go back to our pseudo-quasi-happy existence? Hey, Jerry.
Hey, I heard what happened. Is there anything I could do?
Do you have a way to get back to a pseudo-quasi-happy existence?
I think I might.
Whoa! That was pretty good.
Get a room.
They what? Are you kidding? They'd be stupid to pull this movie. It'll break box office records. No, it's a done deal.
Hi, Miss Day?
Yeah?
I'm Joe, your new cameraman.
Do you have any experience?
Yeah, I shot the bingo finals. Heck, I won an award for that.
Great. Okay, Joe, this is how it works. I point, you shoot. You stay focused and fast on your toes and we'll get along fine. Think you can handle that?
Yeah.
This is big. Look, it's Sunny Day.
Be kind. She saved our lives. Hello, girls.
Oh, hello, Sister Lois, Sister Murphy.
Hello, Pledge.
Hello, Mindy.
Hey.
This must be heck for you.
I manage.
And to think this fest is all about you.
Not directly, but in some sort of 6 degrees of Kevin Bacon way.
So are you coming to our little root beer mixer tonight?
I don't know.
We'll be there.
Oh, good. Because, Mindy, we've got our eyes on you. Bye.
The Delta Lambdas are the biggest
punch. Hey, I'm pledging Delta Lambda.
Oh, my gosh.
Who's that?
Yuri? Hey!
Oh, man, I was worried about you. I heard about what happened and I was on the first flight. Can we talk?
Yeah. Things were going fine until now. Theater's going great. I got my first starring role. We open in 2 days.
That's great!
Yeah, and I'm seeing someone. He's a really nice guy. No apparent psychotic tendencies.
I was just worried. Look, Mindy, if there's some freaked out psycho trying to follow in Willie Loomis's footsteps, then you probably already know him, or her, or them. They're probably already in your life.
You think I don't know that, Huey? What am I supposed to do, crawl under a rock?
No, I'm gonna talk to the local police. I'm gonna make sure you're safe. I'm gonna hang around here if that's okay.
I'd be honored.
Are you all right? Who was that guy?
Just an old friend.
Deputy Huey, Connersville's finest. What's he doing here?
He's worried.
I think I'll go say hi.
Hello, Mindy. Sunny. I was hoping I could get a few words from you with, Dalton.
Hello, Mindy.
Here we are at IU East University, where Mindy Frescott has just been reunited with Dalton Leary after she wrongfully accused him of murdering her mother.
What are you doing?
We want to know what you think.
Mindy, I'd like to say I've learned to forgive and forget. And like you, I want to move on with my life.
You! Nah-uh-uh. Oh, Mindy, please share with us.
I'll share with you. Did you get that on film?
Yes, I got that on film.
You mean she didn't know?
Oh, man, that was cold.
Look, you better check your conscience at the door, sweetie. We're not here to be loved. Huey, what are you doing here?
Can't you just leave her alone? Hasn't she been through enough? And my name is Hubert.
I was just doing my job, Hubert.
No matter who gets hurt in the process.
Hey, who got punched here? Me?
Well, I'd say you deserved it.
Page 32, Deputy Huey fills the room with his Barney Fife-ish presence.
I see that you read my book.
Well, Miss Day, I do read.
Come on, Huey, it was just a character in a book.
Page 41, Deputy Huey oozed with inexperience.
Don't you think you're overreacting just a little bit?
No, what I think is that you're a money-hungry, fame-seeking, and forgive me for saying, a mediocre writer who has a cold storage where a heart should be. No offense intended.
Huey, I never meant to imply.
How do you know that my dim-witted inexperience is merely a subtle form of manipulation used to lower people's expectations, therefore enhancing my ability to maneuver in every given situation?
I don't know what to say, except I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry. I misjudged you. By the way, nice red tint.
Well.
Didn't
I see it? I see it.
We're so glad you can make it.
Hi. No, I really mean it. Hi.
Hi.
Where's Holly?
Oh, she'll be here in a little bit.
You want a root beer?
Yeah, you know what? I do, but I think I'll go get it myself.
I love those guys. I haven't seen them for 3 weeks.
Nope, they broke up. Sarah found out Bailey was cheating on her with Gwen. She dumped him 2 episodes ago. Hold on, I got another call. Omega Beta Zeta. Ted? I gotta go. It's Ted. He sounds like he has had too much root beer. I'll call you back. Ted, what's up? You sound like you've had too much caffeine.
Who's Ted?
Oops, my bad. Who are you calling for? Nobody else is here.
What if I said you?
What if I said goodbye?
Do you want to die tonight, Cece?
Thanks. You guys have really given me a lot to think about. Thanks.
Hey, babe. Wanna dance?
Yeah, with that tall guy over there.
Empire Strikes Back. Improved story, better effects. Not a sequel, part of an original planned trilogy. So are they being nice to you?
Painfully nice.
So I take it you're not going to pledge for Delta, Lambda, Zeta.
No.
Hey guys, something is up at Omega Beta Zeta. Police are everywhere. Hurry!
Go on, get your jacket. Pressure to it.
Ow. Oh.
Hey,
Hey guys, do you think that Mindy would do an interview with for my documentary?
Yeah, after she turned down Dateline 2020 Primetime, but for you, yeah.
I was just thinking of who the killer might be. Have you guys taken a good look at Danny lately?
What?
I mean, I know the guy's innocent the first time through, but you have to admit he's been just a little bit off lately.
Come on, Danny. The guy is harmless.
That's what they said about Dahmer.
Drop it. What's up, Minnie?
Hey.
So how's it going? Where are the Secret Service guys?
Over there.
And which one's Leonardo DiCaprio?
The one on the left is Officer Richards, Gemini, divorced with two kids. And the one on the right is Officer Andrews, Capricorn, single, but I think he's gay.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
So what's on your mind, Jerry?
This morning, I woke up with this feeling I didn't know how to deal with, and suddenly I just decided I'd hide it to myself.
Never
talk about
it. What is
he doing?
And
Tom
didn't
try
to
Tom
shout it when you walked into the room. I think I love you, so what am I so afraid of? Afraid that I'm not sure of a love there is no cure for. I think I love you, isn't that what life is made of? And it worries me to say that I never felt this way. I think I love you.
I wish I had this. Isn't that a big frat no-no?
Oh, that's a big no-no. You see, you're not supposed to give your letters to your girl. No shape, no form. The brothers are going to kick his butt. But it's tradition.
It's tradition.
I want you to have this for protection.
I can't believe it. They get Lisa Garrison to play me. I get Joe Schmoe from Kokomo to play me. At least you got Kyle Kelly. I get the guy who drove the stagecoach for one episode of Dr. Quinn.
Okay, let's get down to business. The way I see it, someone's out to make a sequel. You know, cash in on this movie murder hoopla. So it's our job to represent the rules of the sequel. Number one, the body count is always bigger. Number two, the death scenes are always much more elaborate. More blood, more gore, carnage candy. Your core audience just expects it. And number three, never...
How do we find the killer, Danny? That's what I want to know.
Okay, let's look at the suspects. There's Jerry, the obvious boyfriend. Hello, Willie Loomis.
So you think it's Jerry?
Not so fast. Let's assume the killer or killers has half a brain. He's not a Nick at Night rerun type of guy, and he wants to break some new ground. So forget the boyfriend thing. It's tired. So who else do we got?
There's...
Nicky, a freaky Tarantino film student. But if he's a suspect, I'm a suspect. So let's move on.
Well, let's not move on. What if you are a suspect?
Well, if I'm a suspect, you're a suspect.
You've got a point. Okay, let's move on.
Well, there's the reporter, Sunny Day.
Sunny, a killer?
Why not?
Well, she is vicious.
Isn't it conceivable she's planning her next book?
Nah, Sunny's a lot of things, but Sunny's no killer.
Look, just because you're sweet on her.
No, I'm not.
This is me talking here, Danny, the unrequited love slave of Mindy Prescott. I know all about obsessions and pain.
Yeah, and you got your love scar to prove it.
And so do you. I mean, what's up with that limb? Because you were stabbed in the back.
Severed nerve. Look, Sunny's no killer.
Okay, all right then. But if she's not a killer, she's a target.
Time has played a game with me. My heart has skipped a beat, a path. A tragedy awaits you at the end of the day. Why would you do this to me? My black eyes just began to see the world. My future has just ended today. Once again, I search about the crowd. I search about...
So let's just assume that the killer or killers is planning their next... Hello?
Bob's on the line.
Tell him I'll have to call him back.
Well, it doesn't make sense. Mindy wasn't killed in Cantersville.
Hello?
It's Bob again.
Oh, Bob, I'll call him back, okay? Look, there were more victims. Tanda, my cameraman, Henry.
Hold up for a second here. I don't need to be hearing about no dead cameraman. I'm gonna go get me some coffee, donuts, cracks, Special K, Malcolm X, and I'll be back when y'all start talking about something more saved by the bellish.
He seems a little bit tense.
Don't worry about him. If the killer's trying to copycat, what's next?
I wouldn't copycat any killer.
So what do you want to do about it, Bonehead? See who drops next?
Well, I don't know, Bonehead.
Wait. Sonny's not here.
I'm not interrupting anything, am I? You three look deep in thought.
Him.
Who?
The killer. He can see us.
Just keep him on the phone.
What do you want me to say?
Just keep him talking.
Hi. What's your favorite scary movie?
They'll never find me.
What do you care? Let them have their fun. So what's up?
What's your favorite scary movie?
Showgirls. Absolutely frightening.
Hey!
Come on, Sonny, let's go.
Suspect, trying to clock.
Your clock or my clock?
My clock.
Too slow, geek. Why are you even here, Danny? You'll never be the leading man.
Screw you!
Who is this?
Oh, get off me!
This is Sunny Day, author of the Connersville Murders.
Why copycat two loser high school pooping? Lou was a wussy wet rag. And Billy Loomis, what the heck? What a rat-looking, homo-repressed mama's boy. You want to be one of the big boys? Manson? Bundy? OJ? Ah!
Where's Danny?
Time, Dalton.
Come on, Mandy. You sent me to jail for over a year. Just give me 5 minutes. I'll sit at home, and out of the blue, who calls but Diane Sawyer?
What?
She says if you agree to go on the air with your story, she'll give us the entire hour. Can you imagine that? You, me, Diane Sawyer? We're talking prime time here.
Look, Dalton, I can't.
Look, Mandy, I understand that you don't like the press. I respect that, Mandy. But we're talking Diane Sawyer here. Hello.
Look, between the movie and the book, people know the truth. Why would you want any more exposure?
I don't know, Mindy. Maybe because I deserve a little flippin' exposure. I mean, you drag my name through the mud and everybody thinks I'm some kind of psycho. All I want is a simple interview with Diane Sawyer. Is that so flippin' unreasonable?
I'm sorry, Dalton, but no.
You're sorry? Sorry, huh? Lovable and flipped-up Mindy Prescott. Everybody's favorite victim.
It shouldn't have been Danny. It should have been me.
Don't say that! I'm gonna get the security to take you to a safe place. Pack your things.
I feel really bad, Huey.
Oh, is this just another Sunny Day performance?
There are no cameras here. I just want to find this guy.
What's this stuff?
It's just some crowd footage that Joe shot. Wait a minute. If the killer is really watching and relishing every minute, then you gotta be on this footage somewhere.
Well, it's worth a look. Oh, can I help you with this?
Oh, here we go, Columbia.
It's like we've all done things that were wrong before. And we've all made mistakes in our lives. But that's just the nature of human beings, and we're all only human. Sometimes.
It's locked.
Can you pick it?
That would be breaking and entering.
No crap. What's down there?
Now we're getting somewhere.
Perfect.
Sorry about that.
Okay.
You okay?
Yeah. Look, Huey, I never meant to hurt you.
Over there!
Wait! No, Huey, wait!
Sammy! Sammy! Sammy!
Taking us.
Well, if I told you that, I'd have to kill you. Brothers, they got me for giving you my letters. Now get me out. The killer's here! He's here! He killed Holly!
What are you talking about?
The killer! He's here!
Where?
Right here. So, you think it's your best, Mindy? Don't you know history repeats itself, huh, Mindy?
Oh my gosh. Mindy?
What the heck? Since Jerry here bailed on me, I've been on my own all night. Thanks a lot, partner.
What? Jerry, oh my god.
No, Mindy, no, no.
It's okay, Jerry. We got her.
Mindy, he's crazy. He's lying.
What's the matter, Jerry? Think Mindy's experiencing a little bit of deja vu?
Mindy, he's lying. He's lying. Untie me.
Boyfriend killer. Boyfriend killer.
You're dead. You're dead. I'm gonna kill you. I'm gonna kill you. I never would have hurt you.
You really should start using your trust issues, Mindy. I mean, poor Jerry here didn't stand a chance.
He was smart,
funny, had a decent singing voice, and he was going to be a doctor. Just the kind of guy that you would want to take home to Mom. If you had a Mom.
Both on you!
Oh, so vulgar. Do you think that Willie would have put up with that language?
Willie was a sick poop just like you!
No. You see, Mindy, Willie was a sick guy who wanted to get away. Nikki is a sick guy who wants to get caught. I have it all planned out, Sid. I have my entire defense planned out. Going to blame it on the movies. It's never been done before. I'll have Bob Dole on the stand in my defense. I'll have the Christian Coalition paying my legal fees. It's airtight.
You're a psychotic.
Well, that'll be our little secret.
Oh yeah? There's one thing you forgot about, Willie Loomis. I killed him.
Well, now who could that be? A surprise guest waiting in the wings? Told you I had a partner, Mindy.
Sonny? Mrs. Loomis?
Willie's mother. Surprise, Mindy. Didn't see it coming, did you?
No, it's impossible. I've seen pictures.
It's called a makeover. You should try one. You're looking a little tired there yourself, Sonny.
You two are in on this together?
Wait until the trial. It's gonna rock.
Oh, there's not gonna be a trial, Nikki.
You're never gonna get away with this. You're as crazy as your son was.
What did you say? Was that a negative remark about my son, Willie?
No, Willie was fine.
Willie was perfect. He did a bang-up job, Mrs. Loomis. You better watch what you say. Danny spoke poorly of Willie, and I got a little knife happy.
Isn't Nikki supposed to be dead?
What?
Nobody's flipping moves! I've had a very bad day. I'd like to know what's going on here.
Dalton, meet Mrs. Loomis, Willie's mother.
Who's that?
That's Nikki, the other killer.
Okay.
Look, Dalton!
Shut up! Oh, so hi. You're not Wendy Pepper from the Post-Telegraph, huh?
Look, I can still help you, Dalton. Come on, Dalton. You don't need her. Let me kill her.
No, Dalton, don't you listen to her!
Whoa, whoa. What a predicament you got yourself into, Mindy. I mean, she does make a good point. I bet you that interview with Diane Sawyer is looking pretty good right now.
Consider it done.
That was intense. Look, Mindy, you know I'd never hurt you.
Dalton, give me the gun.
Okay. Mindy, we should discuss what went on here. Get our story straight.
Oh! Somebody get me out of here.
Sonny, are you alright?
Of course not. I've been shot.
My gosh, Sonny, you scared the crap out of me. Is there any more people down there?
Shut up, Dalton.
How bad is it?
I think it just bounced off my rib.
My gosh, you got more lives than a cat.
Is she dead? I don't know. They always come back.
Whoa.
Just in case.
Hey, we got a live one in here.
Huey, is he gonna be okay?
Yeah, Starfish, you saved him.
He's the real hero. He's the one you want to interview. Hey, Donald.
Y'all meet your story. There is indeed a place, time, and a price. If you need me, it's my number.
Oh, come on, Donald. You gotta tell us something.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. You're one heck of a...
I think I love you, but what am I so afraid of? I'm afraid that I'm not sure of a love that is no cure.